Welcome to Learning Equinox. In our video on banking literacy, so far we have discussed on the various types of checks. Today we shall understand the clearing process. How does clearing happen? If you have not yet watched our video on banking literacy so far, please do so. I shall leave the playlist link in the description and towards the end of this video also for you to watch it. If you find this educative and informative, do stay tuned by subscribing to our channel at Learning Equinox, and do not forget to hit on to the bell notification to get notified every single time we upload our videos. Do follow us on Instagram. There, we keep posting on our upcoming courses and programs, and a lot more educative information is uploaded on Instagram. The link to Instagram also is given in the description box. Watch this video till the end to understand the complete process for clearing. So let's get started. Firstly, let us understand the situation where a clearing comes to place. So clearing comes to place only when the check is issued where two banks are involved. So let's say I give a check to Mr. A, who has the account in the same bank as I have, then the process of clearing will not get initiated. If I give a check to Mr. A, who is having an account in another bank, in such a case, then clearing process will take place. So, it's very important to understand that the giver and the receiver of check, both these parties, the accounts are in different banks. Only then clearing comes into place. So, here the issuer of a check gives the check to someone who in turn deposits it in their bank. The banker of the recipient party receives this check at the clearing house, collects the money from the issuer bank and deposits it in the recipient's account. Let's take an example here. So you have issued a check to Mr. A, who has an account in XYZ bank. So Mr. A will deposit the check in his bank. XYZ bank will then approach the clearing house and collect the money from your bank and deposit it in Mr. A's account. It's that simple. Now, in the past, settlements of these banks used to happen only on presentment of the physical checks, that is the physical instruments in the clearing houses. Later in 2010 came the CTS process. CTS refers to check truncation process. And after the check truncation process came into place, it is now happening through digital modes and is an automated process. So let us look at how this happens. But before we proceed, another significant aspect is about the core banking system. With the core banking system, the payee can deposit the check in any branch and not necessarily in his base branch. Thus, if a payee of an account is in Mumbai branch of XYZ bank and he visits Delhi, there also in Delhi he can deposit the check in any branch in Delhi of that XYZ bank, and the bank will process the check. So this is the benefit of iCore system that is available in banking. The core banking system has brought about this convenience of anywhere banking. Okay, so it's important that we understand this bit as well. Now let us look at how the clearing process works. That is, in today's times, I will call it how the CTS works. So CTS runs on the MICR code. As you are aware, there's a MICR code on your check. MICR code refers to magnetic ink character recognition. Now, this is a key significant differentiator for checks. It is a 9-digit code that is uniquely which identifies the bank and the bank branch. The MICR code helps RBI identify the bank and the bank branch. The first 3 digits are the city code where the branch is located. The next 3 stands for the bank code and the last 3 for the code of the branch. So this MICR code helps the clearing system to identify the exact bank and bank branch from where the check has been issued. CTS is image-based clearing process. So instead of manually presenting the checks by the presenting bank here will send images of checks to the CTS location for verification of information. Now, CTS locations are managed by NPCI. NPCI is National Payment Corporation of India, which is a body for all retail payment systems in India. So these CTS locations is where the checks are sent for verification. So the checks are verified for the signature and the information therein. signature validation, whether there's a balance in account of the issuer of the check and so on. Once that verification is done, then the check is marked as cleared in the system. Once this is done, the payers, that is the drawer's bank, pays the fund to the payee bank, which is the presenting bank. Once the funds are received by the presenting bank, they will go ahead and credit the customer account with these funds. So we must appreciate the fact that, as you are aware now, banks do not accept checks with cancellations or counter signatures on cancellations and things like that. The reason for this is image-based clearing. So if the bank is having image-based clearing, the checks needs to be clearly written. So we must appreciate this fact. This is how the entire clearing process takes place in today's times. It's that simple. So hope today's video did give you an insight upon the clearing process at banks. If you like the video, do give it a thumbs up and share it around with others to educate them as well. We shall continue to understand more concepts on the asset and liability products of banks in our upcoming videos. So do stay tuned to Learning Equinox by subscribing to our channel and hit on to the bell notification so that you get notified every single time we upload our videos. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more.